In the 42 years that the Scottish television brand has been on air, with each era having its own on-screen identity. Autumn 1999, a film crew tours the country to shoot the new look. So why is branding so important?
Over a number of years, of course, we've gone from two channels to three to four to five to 200 now, should you wish to get to watch them. And branding is simply a matter in competition and in marketing terms to try and attract the audience to watch and sample and buy your product as opposed to something else. Of course, it's not as simple as that in television. People don't just watch a channel because of the brand. They may like to associate themselves with the brand, and of course that is exceptionally significant. Branding in television only happens with programming in television. It doesn't stand on its own.
The main part of the brief was to update the channel's image, which we felt was long overdue, to keep it Scottish, but with a bit more style. No shortbread, no tartan.
We were keen that the look of the channel was very sort of approachable and welcoming to the viewer. And the brief was also to include people in the Idents. So we were thinking about how can we achieve this, how can we bring people into the Idents and not kind of in a studio environment where it's all very sort of cold and electronic looking.
The thought had occurred, well, we're looking at what to try and do something to capture people in portraiture within the imagery of the brand, and it struck me, I wonder what we could do if we try and combine that with film work. So I mentioned it to Enzo and Mike, and largely the development of that, of course, is from them, because they immediately took it onto a different plane than I had been on with it, because that's the nature of the people they are.
I knew about David Eustace from a few years ago. I knew his work. I'd seen his work in GQ magazine and various publications. We'd actually filmed him for the fashion programme that we used to make at Scottish Television called Get It On, and we'd photographed David at work on several occasions, and so I knew a bit about his style, and I knew that he was very good at photographing people in natural light, not in a studio environment, and it just seems right that he would be somebody that we could approach that would be a possible director for the job.
The director on board and just 10 days to film, the crew sets off on its journey around Scotland.
It's a friend of mine who have this place and her daughter, they're in the city now. So it's to try and get that thing where the young girl goes away to the city to go to university and she's coming back to the people she loves and the places she loves. So it's quite romanticised without it being that sort of parochial, patronising way of the Highlands. I want it to look like she is coming home, we're seeing the train light at the train track, you'll see that as the arrival. Then she'll be walking up the path, the dogs will come pounding towards her. She maybe just dropped the bike in the path, that's just a suggestion, and you'll see her face just smiling, and that'll lead into the distance, you're sort of going away into the horizon. Hopefully it works that way. We've not done any of it yet, so hopefully it works that way, but that's the way I can visualise it all. It's going to be romantic, I suppose, is the word. It's maybe not the best word to describe it, but I want that feeling of warm, homely sort of thing. So there is going to be just shifting focus in the front one. Unfortunately, we've got Seamus who can sort of like interpret what I'm trying to get over in the moving image. The pace is important as well, it's going to be quite slow. It'll make sense hopefully in a couple of hours' time. At the moment, I know what we're trying to achieve, and if we can get it, we're doing well in this sort of weather. As you can see, it's blowing a gale.
Yeah. That's better. Cut it.
top there.
Beautiful, beautiful. Right.
Part of my job was to get together, work with David to work out, you know, how we could pull all these idents together in a short space of time. Part of the brief was to cover the whole of the country, because obviously we're providing idents a corporate look for Grampian Television as well, so we had to really cover the length and breadth of the country in a matter of a few days. So David and I spent 5 days. We did 1,000 miles around Scotland just recceing and looking for potential locations, and then a week later we were back with the full film crew shooting the chosen locations.
Although there are many similarities to photography, for the first-time director, the disciplines of a film shoot can take some getting used to.
I am not having this action and cut. I am not into that at all. I think I'm just a wee bit too... It just doesn't sound like me saying it, you know? It's like some people say it, like, better than I do. So I make it clear what I'm looking for, what I want, without being anal about it. I think because we're quite strong-willed, luckily I'm winning so far, that nobody's failing the big thing. But everybody seems to be happy and it will work out fine. I think too many people try and make the Highlands too romantic, and it almost becomes patronising, you know, that it's almost like they're full of tourists. I don't want that. It's got its own beauty and it's got an amazing character. But this thing that we're doing with the model and Brora and what we're going to do over here, it's got to reflect the Highlands as, yes, a truly lovely place, but it's not a chocolate box, you know. There's real people with real jobs.
It was very much David's concept to bring Seamus in, and the two of them work together. I tend to find that people tend to work in partnerships in this business. So obviously, you know, Seamus has done an awful lot. And when you see him working and you see the output of what he delivers, you can understand why. One of the things that, you know, perhaps we don't do in Scotland is we don't shout about the artistry of people who go abroad to work. Now, Seamus and David spend a lot of time working overseas, doing a tremendous amount of quality work. Maybe we just don't shout about it enough.
Seamus McGarvey was somebody that we did know about, but I'd never worked with before. He's a film cameraman, works in LA, lives in Glasgow, very talented man, brought a lot to the job. He was a friend of David's. David insisted that Seamus was involved, which was a great move for us. He brought the job alive, you know, and gave us some stunning images. So Seamus takes a lot of the credit for the look. Without him, it wouldn't have been the same job. But, you know, we were delighted that he was, we managed to get him. He doesn't often work in Scotland, I don't think. I think he filmed the Slab Boys a few years ago and has recently done films, did a film for Disney in LA. So he's on the up, which is a good coup for us.
Look at that. That's
rainbow.
Lovely, isn't it?
Little rainbow.
Rainbow going right in.
Part of the challenge with David was, why choose a stills photographer to go and shoot live action idents or commercials? And the fact of the matter is, you know, you're looking for somebody who knows how to photograph beautiful images. And the thing with David was, how do we make these images come to life but still retain the look of a stills photograph? And I think we've managed to achieve that. You know, we talked about how to bring movement into each ident. And I think it, you know, it was an interesting project for him as well. Probably the first time he's ever gone this route with his work. And I think the whole thing was very interesting, just seeing him actually, you know, how do I make this still come to life for the television, but still give it his look, his stamp, the Eustace look that that we all know.
David and the film crew have only one day to shoot at this location, and the forecast is rain.
So it's taking a shot every
four seconds.
I think basically what I've selected to shoot is things that do appeal to me. I like the gracefulness of the dancing, and I like the idea of horse pounding along a beach, and the idea of this young girl coming home to her family, and the pride like the guys in Brainish had. And so things, everything has been very personal to me that I've selected to film.
Angus in the middle next to Duncan. Into Duncan, Angus into Duncan standing.
I'm really looking forward to seeing it because it will be the way I see the world. You know, so what I'm seeing is we're filming this. It's going to be the way the end result is anyway. I know it in my head. I can visualise it from that line that you do see something. A friend of mine's a photographer guy called Albert Watson, and Albert's always said, the same in stills, Albert makes great moving images as well. I remember one thing Albert said, and it was, there's a line that comes from the photographer's eye, and it follows it right through to the final print.
Yeah, that's good.
You're the best models I've ever worked with for a long, long time.
Okay,
thanks. Clear, aren't
they? In the lens!
The idea is she's turning up here and this wee woman, we're knocking on her door saying, look, do you mind if we take a photograph of your garden shed?
No problem.
Nice as night, and this truck pulls up with his gear and lights coming out, and it's like, do you think we're building an IKEA outside or something? You get something up here, lights, and this wee garden shed's never been so famous in its life. Right, that's enough.
Oh, that'll be HDMI.
Did you get that? Bang, bang, bang.
What?
That was the sheep. I'm telling you, know what it is? It's the sheep, they've got air guns. They're dangerous, the sheep have got air guns. Baaaaaaah!
Seamus!
The sheep. Come up here, dear, my wife. I can't remember if we were married or not at that point. No, we were married. And I just saw this. She was telling me about this beach, and we came in to see this beach. Our family originally were our Balsour up here. And I was told about this beach. I'm just watching it for these sheep, I don't like them. And we came in to it one day, and I just, honestly, I saw this bit that we've just seen. And I was like, what? And that's not a good bit. So I went around it, and I just fell in love with it. I love this part of the world. I love wee things. Like that wee house just sitting there, and it's visually, I just think it's dynamite. It's like a movie set, and the beach, the sand dunes are just like. It was one of the magazines. I'm not going to say what magazine was. That this basically Luskintyre is the third best beach in the world. You know what I mean? It's an amazing spot.
Yeah, sure. We can bring
bring her closer to the portrait, but if, you know, if we track any further left than that...
We're going to get enough.
Don't run on the beach. Go then.
That one is going to be there, exactly the same bit shoe. So that's, I see that just as a slight pan.
Yeah.
That one maybe no too wide, do you know what I mean?
Okay, so 45.
Wait till a wave comes, wait till time it with a wave coming. See one building up out there, the other one coming out there now. It's building now, any time.
The idea of the present imagery is not only to reflect the places but also the people of Scotland, but to do so in a way that's perhaps more reflective of the times that now exist in Scotland. Perhaps it's a little less brash than has been before. It's a bit more confident. It's a bit more understanding of its own Scottishness, rather than using, you know, a trombone to blast Scottishness out to you. It's using a little bit more of a subtle message that this is Scotland, these are images of Scotland, these are the people of Scotland. We know we're Scottish and we celebrate Scottishness, but we don't necessarily have to jump up and down about it all the time.
Mark, can you charge up the flame, mate?
See, that's 450.
Action! Good, good. Seamus, you happy with that?
I think
you've
got it, it's too
big. I know, what any time, Seamus. Okay, that's it.
Right, Seamus, I'm happy with that. We've got that. Michael, that was brilliant. That's it, that's in the bag. Okay, Seamus, just cutting any time. Seamus, any time.
Oh, no, I mean anything. I'll
just work.
Okay, good. We used models on two occasions, mostly, but we tried to use the real people wherever we could.
Remember what we've done with all the other shoots? Same thing, nothing. Nothing and lots of it. What is happening is, this is called a wing and a prayer. You make that up as you go along.
Why?
It's not really, it is quite controlled, it never does look controlled. But as it's going, we're going to plan. This is just going to be a shot in a pub. It's all went very, very well. And hope it continues to do that. The only problem is that the one person we're going to film in here is now pulled out about an hour before we're going to film, so we're trying to get somebody else. And it's not an operating theatre, you know what I mean? It's been enjoyed, and I'm loving it. I'm having a great time. It's to be either one more than a film crew. I mean, any better. Could do a coffee, though.
Was reflect some of the imagery of Scotland, the places of Scotland, the views of Scotland, but not do so in a sterile way, but do so in a way that also included some of the people of Scotland. Now, that's a relatively wide brief, so we had to spend a bit of time refining that with David and with Enzo and Mike, but the idea was to reflect not only what Scotland was, but the people of Scotland, what they were as well.
This is brilliant.
And when we were lovely young girls,
whole team here is, I am shooting this primarily for me. That's why STV brought me in to sort of like say, right, David, they're taking a chance. They're saying, like, you come in, you do still images, we like what you do, still images. How do you see the world in motion? I'm going to shoot some stuff down low, just in at the feet, because I love the flowing movement. And come in tight on them. We'll do the portrait at the end, which is the same through the whole thing. We've got this portrait. I'm taking someone from an environment and putting them in. Seamus knows exactly what he's doing. We've got, we agree on the same. Both of us are very visually linked. Both of us like the same sort of stuff. So as it's just the two eyes, myself and Seamus has seen, and it's working hand in hand. And that was one of the reasons, only reason I would do this, was in condition that they could get Seamus to come in and do the director of photography. If Seamus wasn't doing it, I wouldn't be here.
We see this series of Idents has been the first of many, and possibly see the creation of these Idents or the creation of Idents as being a showcase for young Scottish talent, or not necessarily young, but new Scottish talent, especially in the field of direction, directing. It's something that we intend to update on a fairly regular basis.
Broadly speaking, I'm very happy. I suspect, you know, it will, some people will be unhappy with it. I can imagine some traditionalists who are used to, you know, wham, bam, thank you, STV imagery, might think it's a little bit subtle and a little bit indirect. But I think they'll grow to like it. There's so many variations on it and so many themes within it and so many ways that you can adapt it, that I think it will grow. Having said that, I do think that it's a bit of a step forward for us, and I'm very pleased with the work that everyone involved in it has done. But ultimately, of course, it's not for me to judge, it's for the person out there to judge whether they like it as well and whether it captures what they think their television station should be all about.
That sounds then, Alex. See if you can get in your pockets and let's go here. Jim, thank you very much and good night.